Hey everybody, this is Nick. I wanted to jump on really quick because I learned a really fun trick for cropping photos in PowerPoint. It's very, very easy. And if you've ever spent hours and hours and hours trying to copy, crop photos to different sizes and to specific dimensions, this trick is going to be amazing for you. So I first heard about this trick from Nolan Haims over on the Presentation Podcast. Give them a listen. He said he learned it from Steve Sheets, I think, at Ghost Ranch Communication. Never met you, Steve, but I follow your newsletter. It's really great. Everyone out there should follow as well, subscribe as well. So it's always fun to see all these tricks kind of like morph. It's like a big game of telephone, I think, throughout sort of the world of like PowerPoint communication. But anyway, so my take on this is potentially if you ever wanted like a page or a slide with a photo collage or something like that, that can be really difficult. So the first thing I think about if I was going to set up a photo collage on a slide is setting up a grid with the guide. And of course, we've had lots of videos of that, but I would use my Brightslide add-in for that. Go to the Guides tab right here, Create Guides. You could add to Master, to the Layout, to the Normal View. Let's just add it to the Normal View right here, and you can see I can set up my number of columns and number of rows. I have a 9x9 right here. You could do 6x6, 3x3. And then you can also adjust the gutter, so you could put this to zero. You could set these all to zeros if you didn't want any sort of spacing around, but I'm going to have a little tiny bit of space around. So you could click on that, and then you see these guides right here, and you can sort of snap pictures or think about how you want to lay out your photo collage with those guides. I'm going to actually go back to my Brightslide guide tab right here and delete the guides because I don't really want them. I think they're kind of distracting for this demo. So I'm going to delete all the guides. This is the basic layout that I made for my photo collage, and I just made this with shapes. And so I kind of want these photos to be in sort of irregular sizes. So this is where this photo trick is going to come in. I copied this slide over here, and over if I zoom back, I have 9 photos in my photo collage, and I've just downloaded all these from stock photos. They're all classroom photos of classes, classrooms and kids. So let's just go ahead and do this really quickly on the side. So this is where how the stock photo came in. It's sort of this nice, this really big, nice, good resolution, widescreen sort of dimension here, or that the landscape dimension. So if I wanted to just crop these into specific sections here, I'm going to actually just go ahead and I'm going to resize the photo just like this, and I'm just going to squish it. And we always say, oh, we don't want to squish the photos, but with the photo selected, go up to the picture format tab, click on the crop, and then you're going to say fill. Instead of fit, we're going to say fill. And when you do that, it fills that space that you've squished it to, but then it pops it out so that it's proportional. And then if you wanted to, you could go ahead and drag the photo in within those crop boundaries, click on crop, and now your photo is perfect. So we could do the same thing with, let's see, this one. I'm going to go ahead and just squish this one right here, and we're going to squish it up. Squish this one down. And this is where those guides will come in play. If you had guides on the on your screen, on your layout, you'd be able to snap these photos kind of into place. This is another great technique, also not for photos, but if you're laying out dashboards or things like that, data dashboards on your slide. So again, picture format, crop, fill, super fast. It's gonna go right there. You could adjust it however you wish. The other cool thing that you can do within photos is you can also make sure within that crop area, you can also kind of zoom in. So I'm going to hold down the shift key and it'll just proportionally drag that photo within, and then I can just drag that through. And now that creates a really nice image. You don't have to be bound to the settings that the photo came with, or you can crop in, crop out, do all of those things within these boundaries here. Here's another one right here. This is for a small one. I'll just drag this in, and then we're going to drag this up so that the photo is nice and squished, but then we're going to say crop, fill, and it's going to fill the space that I cropped it with. And maybe I'm going to make that a little bit bigger too. Perfect. Click crop. And so from here, it's just kind of formatting how you wish to do it. Depends. You could do this in sort of an endless number of ways, particularly when as long as you have sort of rectangle or square shapes that you want to crop these to, fill. I'll do like that. I should probably have some like music playing or something like this while I do this. But you know, you've probably logged off by now. You get the idea. But anyway, so when you want to crop photos fast and to really nice, dimensions like this, don't worry about cropping it and trying to crop it to a shape or trying to figure out what dimensions you really need. Just do this. Just squish it to the size that you need it, and then use that crop fill. And that's gonna be all you really need. Super fun trick. And I've used it a few times now after learning about it. So super thanks to Nolan and Steve for giving us this trick. Let's see if we can fill this. There we go. Just drag that down. Crop. And we'll do this one. I think a lot of times you may or may not have like a photo collage like this to do this in. The other way that you might think about doing this is setting up a layout, a very specific layout for your collage on your slide master, and just adding photo placeholders, picture placeholders, just like this on your master. And then taking all these photos and just dragging them onto the slide, and they'll automatically populate those picture placeholders. You'll have to go through and sort of maybe crop them individually just to make sure that they all look how you want them to look within those placeholders. But that can be another really good strategy to using picture placeholders for, you know, something like a photo collage slide here. To fill, perfect. I have one more, so I might as well just finish this collage, right? I'm just gonna squish that into place. And oops, all the way down, squish that into place there. Crop, fill, very nice. All right, put it in slideshow mode. A really nice photo collage slide. Super easy to do. I might wanna go through, clean some things up, make sure some things are aligned. Again, that's why you wanna set up your guides, but anyway. I really love this trick. So thanks again, Nolan. Thanks again, Steve, for the trick. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for y'all, and I can't wait to see you next time.